ओम स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणे अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयो श्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः यथाग्नेर्दाहिका शक्ति रामकृष्णे स्थिता हिया सर्वविद्यास्वरूपां तां शारदां प्रणमाम्यहं नमः श्रीयतिराजाय विवेकानन्दसूरये सच्चित्सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिनेतापहारिणे अखण्डमण्डलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः हरिः ॐ तत्सत् ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ नमस्ते टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड विश यू ऑल गुड हेल्थ स्ट्रेंथ पीस जॉय फेथ इन श्री रामकृष्ण फेथ इन द डिवाइन मदर फेथ इन स्वामीजी फेथ इन अवर सेल्फ फेथ इन द कंट्री फेथ इन द सिस्टम ऑल दिस पुट टुगेदर इज वन इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड कॉल्ड श्रद्धा श्रद्धावान लभते ज्ञानम तत्परः संयतेन्द्रियः ज्ञानम लब्ध्वा पराम शांतिम अचिरेणाधिगच्छति सो मैन ऑफ श्रद्धा हुम वी कॉल श्रद्धावान इन द भगवद्गीता एज बलवान बुद्धिमान श्रद्धावान इट्स ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सो मेनी वंडरफुल थॉट्स वंडरफुल क्वालिटीज विच मैनिफेस्ट एज वन इंपॉर्टेंट वेपन कॉल श्रद्धा 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 अनफॉर्चुनेटली श्रद्धा वैनिश्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी आर इन अवर प्रेजेंट स्टेट So let us give up this awful disease, this awful lack of seriousness, and once again rouse that Shraddha in us. Swami Vivekananda's exhortation, Swami Vivekananda's boost to us, to the weak mind, Shraddha, Shraddha. And that man of Shraddha will gain this quality very quickly. So there is no doubt about it. So Sri Ramakrishna says, even if a man, a sadhaka, has mustard seed, of Shraddha, that quantum, that little quantity of Shraddha, mustard seed, avalu, that itself is very, very small, but if that much of Shraddha is there, he can cross the oceans, he can cross the sufferings, can overcome the sufferings rather. So Sri Ramakrishna's teaching, Sri Ramakrishna's parables have to be spread far and wide. People know it, people have studied the book called Pictorial Parables of Sri Ramakrishna, Tales and Parables of Sri Ramakrishna, Sayings of Sri Ramakrishna, elders, devotees are studying the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna. But the application is missing. It is not just devotion that matters. You just don't go to the doctor and be devoted to the doctor and praise the doctor and not take the medicine. That is not the way. So we have to take the medicine. We have to feel the bitterness of the medicine in the throat. And then, whether it's Ayurveda, whether it's homeopathy, whether it is English medicine, whether it is holistic medicines, whether naturopathy, finally Venkatachalapathy. So what we require is that inner drive, that application is important than just devotion. Yes, devotion, if you have surrendered completely, Sharanagati, absolutely no ego, no other doubts and total A faith in the Lord that He will take care. So then it is okay. But as long as I have a ego or you have a ego and we have our own whims and fancies, our own illogical reasonings, then we are far from the goal. We have to follow the rules of the game. So these are some of the very important pedagogy, some of the important tools that we have to understand for Sri Ramakrishna's teachings. So one of the teachings is searching for the right thing in the wrong place. Sri Ramakrishna used to tell, searching for the right thing in the wrong place is not to be done. Right thing in the right place. A fool does it. An ignorant fellow does it. An illiterate may do it. But the man of discrimination has to understand this. So Sri Ramakrishna's story of a fool's search is a villager, a poor man who got up in the middle of the night. He wanted to have a smoke, light up a cigarette. Some people have this habit in the middle of the night. Some will have tea, some will have water, some will have the smoke, varieties, let them have it. But this fellow found that his matchbox was empty. They could not realize his that the matchbox was empty. So in that desperation, he thought, let me just go to my neighbor's house and borrow a matchbox in the middle of the night. So he went to the neighbor's house, but before going, it was a dark night, no street light. And but in the villages, you know, there will be this lantern, kerosene deepam. He increased the flame of it, holding it in his hand. With the help of that light, he goes to the neighbor's house at 1 o'clock in the night and wakes him, knocks the door, wakes him up and says, why did you wake me up in the middle of the night? Sir, give me a matchbox. Why do you need a matchbox? I want to light up my cigarette. You fool. You have a light in your hand, you have a lantern in your hand. With that lantern, you have come to my house asking for a matchbox. And he gave him a nice slap instead of a matchbox, you know. And that man realizes that that moment alone that he has got a light in his hand. So Sri Ramakrishna, the master storyteller, and the way he conveyed the highest Vedantic truths of God, of samadhi, of realization, of concentration is amazing. So he says, God is so nearer to us, he is so close to us. He is the Antaryami, he is just before you, he is just above you. Where Krishna says, I am above you, I am below you, I am to your side, I am to your back, I am everywhere, I am all around you. Take care, I am. Be aware that I am there with you. So what a man seeks is very, is near him, but he searches for it far away. Similarly, our youth today, search for the right thing in the right place. If you do not know, if you are not aware, if you are ignorant of the road, of the process, please approach the great ones. Uttishtata, jagrata, prapyavaran nibodata. Prapya, pondali. In Telugu we say pondadam. Anugraham pondali. You should obtain the blessings of God. The blessings of the great ones, the realized masters. You have to go and search for them. Like people go and search for the right school or the right teacher or the right coach for sport or for other things. But why not for this important mental game or the spiritual game? So Sri Ramakrishna says, search for the right thing in the right place and know that God is near you, is within you. Just give that U-turn. Just change that process and then you will reach God. So don't take the lantern and go to somebody's house. So this is a very interesting story, a very practical story also. Then we have the famous story which Sri Ramakrishna told Swami Vivekananda, and Vivekananda told it in the whole world, the lion and the sheep story, which is very famous. I am not going to it. The guru comes in the form and awakens that divinity inside, shows us the right path and makes us more vigilant, more aware of our real nature. So Vivekananda heard this story from his master Sri Ramakrishna when he was still Narendra, and that story he spoke in the Parliament of Religions and in the Jnana Yoga lectures, and it is very practical of how we lose our identity, lose our originality, and then succumb to pressures and succumb to the worldly desires. So we have to be careful as far as the sheep is concerned. Don't fall into the trap of a sheep and tell, I am a sheep, I am a sheep, gorrenenenu anukokunda, nenu simhamuni, nenu naalo aa balam undi, naalo shakti undi. That faith, that assertiveness. Swami says, assert it. That is your real nature. Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Swabhavaha. It's not just listening to me in the Facebook or in the classes in the Ramakrishna Mat or anywhere else, but the absorption, that Smaran Manan, Smarati Nityashaha, recollect that thought as much as possible while you are walking, while you are eating. So let that bell ring in your subconscious mind and you feel you are moving towards that goal, or you are being taken by your hand towards the goal. Then I want to share with you about concentration today. Sri Ramakrishna's teachings about concentration. How you should concentrate on the mantra. How you should concentrate on the Omkara. How should you concentrate on the form of God? So there he says, in deep meditation, a man is not at all conscious of the outer world. He tells his indriyas, tells his eyes not to see anything else except the Atma Jyoti. Not to listen to anything else except the sound of the Om or the Ishta Mantra. Not to talk anything else. So all the indriyas are closed. And today we have automatically been asked to close by Mr. and Mrs. Coronavirus. We have to close our nose with a mask. We have to close our mouth with the mask whenever we are going out. I cannot do that. I am inside this hall, inside my room, sharing this thought, so it's okay. So nobody is coming to the mat. We have not much of public interaction. But people in the market, it's compulsory that you have to go, and that is how the indriyas are closed externally. But what about the manas with the indriyas? There we lose the game. There we fumble, mumble and jumble. Akkada goyilo padtam. Akkada dari tapputunnam. But in meditation, in regular practice, in concentration, we have to be very alert and we have to keep up that focus. So Sri Ramakrishna tells the story of a fisherman who came and put that iron ball with that hook, angler, we call it. He put it into the water and he's confident that there is fish in the water. He's seeing the fish in the water. And with that faith, he holds on to that practice. So he is waiting. It's a waiting game. He cannot be restless. He cannot be impatient. Shanti, 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 has to tell his mind 100 times. So the ball, the iron ball with the hook, is slowly sinking into that water. And he is operating. He is operating that angle. And slowly as it operates, his entire concentration is on the water. He is on the fish, and fish are there swimming all around merrily, and this fellow has put some worms or some food to that hook, and fish that is dangling inside, that is just floating in the water. And some fish are tempted, some fish run, disappear, they swim away. And you know what happens? This man, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, no moment. Sthira Sukha Asanam. So he is steady. He is gazing at that water, he is gazing at the fish, and is waiting. Perchance one fish will get caught and he will pull it out. That is his business. That is his food. Atani aharam, atani sampada ade. He cannot just say, hey, fish, come into my net or get caught up in this hook and I will pull you and eat you. Impossible. So he has to play a waiting game. At that moment, Sri Ramakrishna says there is disturbance. There is a test for him. There is an obstruction for him. Somebody is playing the shanai, playing the nadaswaram, because near the village river or the reservoir, there is a road and people are coming. Maybe it's a marriage party and there's a dance. There are so many things going on. And this fellow who has come last 15 minutes sitting there, he doesn't move. He doesn't even nod his head. He doesn't even shake his head. He doesn't even see. He is disinterested. That is called dispassion. That is called detachment. Why bother when it is not connected with you? Students come and ask me, I am not able to concentrate, distraction, attraction, and so many things, negative thoughts. Do you really want it? Are you interested in those negative thoughts? Are you interested in those attractions? No. If it is no, it's a no. If it is yes, stop your study, stop your this one, go finish the game, eat something and come back. But here is a fisherman who says no to his mind. He is not interested in any other thing but catch fish. So half an hour is gone by, fish is not yet caught, and still he has to wait. Does he leave it and go for a tea party, for a dance party? Not at all. He has to wait. And there is another obstruction. Once he wins that physical disturbance, then somebody comes near him and, sir, I'm new to this house, new to this village. Can you tell me how to go to so-and-so residence, so-and-so place? Say, I have to go to Osman University if you are in Hyderabad. So how do I go? Which way? It's confusing. So please help me. This man, this fisherman who is totally concentrated on the fish and his angle, is not responding. Second time, third time. The stranger, the visitor, is so annoyed. He says, say yes or no. I will wait or I will go. And that also no response. So he scolds him, curses him, and goes his way. By the time, say he has, from that place, from here, he has gone to that another room, say 2 furlongs. What does he do? This fisherman has got that hook, has got the fish caught up in the hook. He pulls it out, runs behind that man, calls him, apologizes to him and says, please, excuse me. At that moment, I was concentrating on the fish. I could not answer your question. Now I will answer your question. I will take you towards the university. I am living there. This man says, what? Are you playing with me? 3 times, 4 times I asked you. You did not even respond, and now you say, I know the way. This man tells him why he did not attend. Look at the methodology which Sri Ramakrishna is teaching. The idea of concentration, the idea of involvement, the idea of loving God, the idea of meditation. Can I practice 1% of that? A 2% of that concentration in my sadhana, in my upasana, in my prayer, in my chanting? Then you are a winner. You are on the march. You have won 20% of that game. So that dedication, the determination, the dispassion, all these have to be combined. If the fisherman has got that fish, has spent half an hour, 1 hour to catch 1 fish or 2 fish, and Sri Ramakrishna says, our task is much easier. God is nearer to us. He himself, Sri Ramakrishna himself, is nearer to us. Why don't we go to the temple? Why don't we go and do this smaran manan? Repetition, concentration, that purifies. And when the mind is purified, Sri Ramakrishna will reveal himself to us. He will talk to us. May not be like the magic show, may not be like the film show where the light comes and this comes, the colors comes. No. He will just be with us. We can feel his presence. We can feel the divinity of Sri Ramakrishna. Feel the divine presence of Sri Ramakrishna. Divine presence of Swamiji with us. Divine presence of Holy Mother with us. Have that faith, have that joy. Sri Ramakrishna's stories are so simple but so deep. Swami Vivekananda says, I can explain this story for days and days together. Every story is so pregnant with depth and philosophy. So what he observed in Kamarpukur, what he observed here and there, he put it into practical Vedanta. So we are fortunate to have the Ramakrishna Kathamritam. We are fortunate to have different books. All of you, whoever is watching this and who will watch this in future, will understand. So let us make the best use out of it and spend the time of the lockdown in introspection, prayer and everything. May Sri Ramakrishna bless us. And for today, let us remember these 2 stories. One is the fool's search for the right thing in the wrong place, and another is the fisherman trying to catch the fish, winning over the obstructions, winning over the difficulties in his attempt. So in our life, anugraham and our prayatnam should go together, and let us reach the goal as early as possible. So we shall stop here and continue later. ओम शांति 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 ही हरि ही ओम तत्सत श्री राम कृष्णार्पणमस्तु लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु। थैंक यू। हरि ओम। नमस्ते।